Howdy, welcome to Let's Play IL-2 Stormovic with me, Nob, which will do our Stormovic Submetria campaign. We got 7 aircraft kills and we have 101 ground kills, including a ship that we're very proud of. We have 2 medals, Order of the Red Banner and the Order of the Red Star. We have a score of 5203, whatever that means. We finished 17 missions, we died 14 times while doing so. So mission number 18, south of Rasin. 10th of August, 1945, 6:30 in the morning, weather is clear, located is still Sukaya Reka. Mission briefing, I downed my frontline 100 grams, sitting on the barracks porch. The trick was not to swallow, just pour it in. So the frontline 100 grams is what Russian, I think the government rationed out to the people on the frontline. It's 100 grams of alcohol, I think vodka, probably. Tastes like shit, it says so right here. But it's just to get them a little bit tipsy at night so they can get some sleep so they can fight the next day. I listened to the rain for a few minutes and then went to my bunk and my eyelids finally closed shut. After what seemed like a second, my eyelids opened automatically and I was wide awake. 5 a.m. right on the clock as usual. The rain stopped and the new dawn was beginning to glow in the east. The strong breeze from the bay was chilly, unsummer-like. I flagged down a supply truck, hopped on, and jumped off at the squadron command post. Slowly, other pilots began to gather inside. I greeted each one, made sure they slept well. A couple of them didn't sleep throughout the night, so I grounded them for the day. There were probably more people like them, but after I grounded those two, everybody else reported that they slept like babies. So everyone wants to fly. That's good. I knew last night was difficult for those guys in the war. In war, airfields are alive 24 hours a day, and it's not easy to get a good night's sleep with trucks roaring by, airplane engines being run up next door, and aircraft weapons being test firing. To check their alignment. At 5:30 a.m., most of the pilots went to get their breakfast, getting a frontline ration for the first time in their lives. I knew they wouldn't miss it. I just had a glass of hot water as usual and went down to the hangars. My IL-10 looks huge from outside, a mighty predator basking in the morning sunlight. Gun muzzles stuck out like talons, rockets with the red tips under the wings like swords dipped in blood. Okay. The mechanics were sitting on some crates behind the plane smoking. They jumped up when they saw me saluted, and chief mechanic made his report. I saluted back and did my walk around quietly, deliberately, carefully. The plane was impeccable. I shook the mechanic's hands. 5 minutes later, I reported in to get my orders. This time they were simple. 4 IL-10s needed to fly out to Rasin and to search along the railroad leading south and to destroy enemy trains, especially the ones moving into the city. So we're stationed here. We're gonna fly down southwestward. And all these gray lines are, I think, railroads. So there'll be some trains moving in and out of Rasin here. They're probably coming from the southwest, and they'll probably try to resupply Rasin by the railroad. And our job is to destroy the supply trains. The objective: destroy enemy trains south of Rasin. There'll be 4 IL-10s taking off, each carrying 4 of the RS-82, the rockets. Maintain an altitude of 1300 meters. The 4 rockets here, we can carry other stuff, but we're gonna stick with the one we have. And there are the rockets underneath our wings, dipped in red blood, it says. There's a red tip in the front. We'll have 4 of them. We're gonna fire the outer pairs first, and then the inner ones. They'll all converge 500 meters in front of us, and they'll all blow up 5 seconds after I fire them. So we'll take about 70% fuel quantity, hopefully that's good enough. We'll take off and keep going straight, pretty much. Heading 231. And that's the 1300, that's what I said earlier. And we'll try to find Rasin, and then we're gonna head south of it, southwest of it, and try to shoot our rockets and blow up the trains around here, and come back through the water where it's safer, because there's no flax. I think we're gonna use our rockets on the locomotive, on the first cart, the engine of the train, and then maybe use our cannons and guns on the rear carts, the cargo cars in the back. So probably it's a little bit softer than the locomotive. So we do all this engine startup procedures. So it's early in the morning, 6:30. That's the four of us in the morning fog. I don't see anything else in the sky except for the misty sun out there. Clear to take off. Holding down my wheel brake, throttle up, gently and slowly. Once the plane starts moving, let go of the wheel brake. Use the yaw. There's a truck over there. Let's try to center the plane. Using the yaw rudders. This plane levels itself off on the ground. We're going fast enough. You don't have to pitch down. Although you may want to if you're carrying a lot of weight and a lot of bombs and stuff. But we're carrying just a few of the rockets. The red tips. Here we go, we're going. So we want heading of 231, I believe. That's what I said. We're going 240 right now. So that's 231 right here. So we're gonna fly like this. We're gonna gain some speed, gain some altitude, and we're gonna cruise on out there. We have a long, long ways to go. Hopefully nothing will happen. I'll be back once we get nearer to the Rasin area. Yeah, I see some dots up there. I just heard on the radio about a minute or two ago my guys dropping bombs. Not my guys, but some of the Russians dropping bombs. And these guys must be it, TU-2s. I see three flights of three planes. There's quite big bombers here, TU-2s. They just dropped something, some bombs out there somewhere. Or maybe down there, I don't know. But we're nearly at the Rasin area. That's Rasin right there, I think. Oh, I think that's the Yuki or whatever is north of Rasin. But the Rasin's the next bay, basically. I'm gonna head closer to east. Did we just hear something? We just climbed up a bit because we were taking a look at the TU-2s, but we were going altitude 1300 meters. And that's Rasin right there. So we're gonna head south of that area. My guys seem to be backing off. Well, they sound like they're backing off. So Uh-oh. Fight is 8 o'clock. We have no escorts today. Just the four of us. TU-2s aren't gonna help us. Ki-61 spotted. Two of them. Ki-61 is probably the best Japanese inline engine fighter plane there is. There was. So we are in trouble here. There's at least two of them out there. I'm gonna pick up some speed. I'm not sure if we can outrun them. They are probably the best Imperial Japanese Army airplanes, maybe, other than Ki-100s, which are practically the same plane but with the radial engine. But yeah, we are at our destination here. We're at the south of Rasin here. That's Rasin right there. So we don't want to get too close to it because there are guns on the ground, I think. But I see some road. I see the railroad. I haven't found the trains. But I believe this is the railroad? I don't know. I gotta have to get down a little bit closer. But yeah, we are, we do have to worry about the KI-61s. We do have our rear gunners protecting our backs. This is not the railroad. One of those roads may be the railroad. I see the car. I see the trains. I see the train. Alright, I'm not gonna fire my rockets just yet. I see two trains. I'm gonna fire my guns and try to bring the train to a stop. Oh, they're firing back. Maybe there's an explosion. There's another train out there. You see it smoking. They tried to get the hell out of here. They see me. They hear me. They feel me. They don't want me or anywhere near them. So they're trying to get the hell out of there. But there's no way a train can outrun a plane. Now we do have to worry about the KI-61s. Now if I can help it, I'll stop this train as well. Alright, my guys are doing work. Look at that. Huge explosions. Alright, seems like they are going out of the city. We were more interested in the trains that are moving into the city, but we may be too late for that. Uh-oh, Bob shooting. My rear gun is shooting. Does that mean there's a KI-61 behind us? Which way, Bob? You gotta tell me. Yeah, they're shooting at me. I hear them. I don't see the tracers. I think they are to my left. I pull over to my right. Yeah, they are to my left. Oh, jeez. Oh, yeah, there he is. I can't quite catch up to him. That's number two right there. Alright, you change your plans, guys. Gotta use teamwork to get these planes out of our air before we can work on the trains. We actually did enough damage to the trains, and we actually may be too late to get the trains. Seems like they're moving out of the Rasin area. They may have dropped their supplies off already. Nonetheless, it's always a good idea to destroy the trains. Oh boy. Sorry, Bob. Has to be done. Still shooting at me. I'm gonna fly right at this my wingman here. Hopefully he can get that guy off me. I don't hear him. My behind. Can't see shit. I wish they had mirror or something in my plane. But no, I don't have anything. I can't see anything at all. Not even my rear gunner. I turn around. There's the both of them. They were both chasing me. My number four is going at them. They're pulling out to the sea, which is good. Four shooting at number two. I have to team up with them. And he's overheating. I do have some speed on these guys, but they can accelerate faster than I can accelerate, so I can't outturn them, that's for sure. Now I'll dive in maybe? I don't know. They are quite heavy as well. Where's the rest of my guys?
Yes,
the 4 is here, number 2 is here. Come on, number 2, you gotta get to fight this. I don't know where my number 3 is. He may be gone. The 4 is on number 2. Where's number 1? Maybe behind me. I don't know. Bob's keeping an eye out there. Alright, it's going over there. There's no way we can do that maneuver. Not with our plane. Oh, there's the bomb site. That's what the TU2's bomb. Let's keep the radiator position number 2. I still don't see the KS-16 number 1. I don't know where he went. Maybe right behind me, for all I know. But we're getting out on this number 2 guy. I hear some flaks behind me as well. That's definitely enemy flaks. We are not near our territory. The KS-61 is one of the best jet... best Japanese army fighter. We are keeping up with them, so that means... Holy crap, what was that? That means we are no slouch ourselves, the IL-10s. The IL-2s would have no chance. They would just have to out-tank the guns of KS-61s. But we, the IL-10s, can match can almost match their flying speed. Look at that. Number 4 got him. Left the wingtip off of the KI 61 number 2. The pilot bailed out. Where's number 1? Splash 1 bandit. I don't know where number 1 is. I'm gonna pull my guys back here. Yeah, I don't see number 3. I don't hear number 3. I think number 3 is gone. The flags are onto us. Now we still have the rockets. All the rockets. And the trains were here, a little bit further south. Somewhere. South of these towns, I think. Over these hills, I think. No? I feel like it's further south than here. Oh yeah, there they are. I see the trains. Train number 1, train number 2. This one's badly damaged. There's 2 cars left, and maybe the locomotive is still alive, I don't know. Try to finish off these 2 locomotive, 2 cars in the back. It does. There we go. And they do explode. And the explosion could potentially hurt me. So I don't want to get as close as I just did right there. Alright guys, my guys are here with me, so I'm gonna tell them to go ahead and resume attacking the trains. That's the other train. 4 cars. I think the locomotive is burnt on the car. That's the front car, the engine. You can't tell from here, but I think it's destroyed. So all we gotta do is take care of the 4 cars in the back. And I'm gonna spend my rockets on the locomotive on the second car, the one back here. Cause that doesn't look like it's being burnt. I'm gonna approach it perpendicularly from the ocean here. Japanese farmland or Chinese farmland. I don't know. It's Manchuria. It's Chinese territory occupied by Japanese at the moment. Russians are trying to liberate it. Let me see if I can shoot both of these things. Yeah. Rockets away. Push the wrong button. Alright, second pass on the rocket from this side. Hang in there, Bob. Doing a loop here. Spend my last rocket on a locomotive. Rocket away. Boom, it's a hit. Alright, so I'm out of rockets now. No rockets. I do have some guns and cannons. We're gonna finish off those four remaining cars and then we're gonna head home. Hopefully, we won't run into that Ki-61 anymore. And I'm afraid we lost number 3. That train is completely defenseless. I don't know who's in those cars. But they are fucked. Anything else? This is the dirt road. There were a lot of railroads around here, but I just can't seem to find any, except for this one. All right, let's try to finish this off. Get out of here before more enemy planes can take off. Going in, right? Just me. Got it. Yeah, look at the damage on our plane. We're missing the left elevator. So if we take a look at the map now, we still have two trains here. Wish they would go away, but we still have them. So, and those are the right trains. We'll do one more pass on each of these trains. Take a look if there's anything else that we can destroy. Something's smoking. I don't know why. But can you guys attack the train? Number 2 can. It's pretty much destroyed, I think. The T-2s are landing, I think. I think we're done. Crew is dead here. Nothing. We're done. Getting out of here. Let's go out by the ocean. Hopefully a fewer flags are out there. I don't know where my guys went.
Ухожу на следующий круг. Десятый. Внимание. Полоса занята. Посадку не разрешаю.
That's Rasin out there.
Второй круг. Я десятый. Ухожу на следующий круг. Одиннадцатый. Внимание. Полоса занята. Посадку не разрешаю.
Perfectly peaceful city before we showed up.
Я одиннадцатый. Ухожу на следующий круг. Седьмой.
Well, before the Japanese showed up.
Полоса занята. Посадку не разрешаю. Уходите на
второй круг. Enemy airbase out there.
Я седьмой. Ухожу на следующий круг.
I don't see any planes on it.
Я пятый. Разрешите посадку.
That's the other port.
Разрешите посадку. Я шестой.
Couple of holes in my left wing.
Я пятнадцатый. Разрешите посадку.
We survived that.
Я четырнадцатый. Разрешите посадку.
We lost that one airplane. I don't know where it went. KI-61 number one. I didn't see the number three. I didn't see him after we took off. I'm not seeing any of anything right now, to be honest. I don't know where my guys are, but hopefully they're going home. That's where we're going. I'm just looking out here, but we're gonna follow this coastline. Just barely outside of it because of any enemies are on the land. We're gonna fly on top of the water, but we're gonna follow this coastline until we follow our home, until we find our home. I'll be back once we get there. We're flying over our airbase. Shut up, please. That'll shut up the radio. TU-2s are still landing. I don't know what takes them so long to land. But they were landing when we were attacking the train. We flew all the way back and they're still landing. There were 9 of them. And I still haven't seen my guys. Raise up my prop pitch. Roll the throttle, open up the radiator. Fuel mixture should be still at 100%. I haven't seen my guys, I don't know where they are, but I'm gonna tell them to go land. I'm gonna go land. I don't see anyone else trying to land, so I'm gonna go land. External lights, landing lights. Make sure my tail wheel is not locked. Here. I think I'm too low. What's that TU-2 doing in front of this? Am I supposed to land from the other side? No, this guy just landed. I'm going the right way. Alright, flaps down. Gears down. My landing light. Alright, this is good. Oh. Bumpy landing. I don't want to hit you, TU-2. Well, I don't want to do that either. This is my statue of IL-10 in the ground. It's not bad at landing. No, it's terrible. Who's this guy? Is that one of my wingmen out there? I don't know. It's gotta be maybe my number 2 and number 4 here, I don't know. But they're on their way back. I guess this is the KI-61 number 1. Yeah, it's him. Look at that paint job. I know some of the locals here spray paint their cars like that. All right, so there are some planes out here as well. I think these are 61s as well. It's KI-61. Japanese Imperial Japanese Army airplane at their best. They are outnumbered, out-technologized, I don't know, is that a word? Probably not. Oh, and here's my plane. That's Bob in the back. Yeah, he's used to this. Alright, so number 2 circling around, number 4 circling around, number 3 is nowhere to be seen. Here's the TU-2. A big rear gun. They have hangars underneath. They can drop their bombs, unload their bombs.
Right, so
except for number 3. And of course, this is unmistakably us. Yeah, that's great. Someone get me out of here, please. Alright, so we have some train kills. A lot of train kills. We have scores 5, 6, 7, 3. No new award. Let's apply this. Looks like next mission is going to be on the same day, 10th of August. After the morning sortie, I stuck around by my plane, discussing something with the mechanics. There was something wrong with the back of my seat, and I was asking if they could file off or do something about the rivets that were chewing holes through my shoulder blades. The mechanics looked stunned. Suddenly somebody tapped me on my shoulder. "Captain, may I speak with you, sir?" I turned around and saw new Lieutenant Sokov, a young kid we received a few months ago, straight from the flight school. "What is it?" I need to talk to you, sir." "Go right ahead. Privately?" "How saucy." "Sure, Sokov. No problem." This guy's name changes. Sokov. We walked through the grass quietly. I lit up a cigarette, offered one to Sokov. I could see he was nervous. "Well, what's the matter, Lieutenant?" "Sir, I just can't do it. Can you?" "I can't shoot up a train car like that. There are people there, defenseless, just sitting with nowhere to go. I'm a combat pilot. I need to go to the battlefield and hit enemy troops, not this. When you're assigning pilots in the future missions, can you just..." I sighed. "Why don't we go to the political officer, Sokov?" Lieutenant's eyes opened wide. "Don't worry, Sokov. Relax. Gerasimov's a great guy, not one of those. He'll help you out. Much better than I ever could." Sokov nodded, not fully believing me. He seemed resigned to his fate as we went around the airfield looking for Major Gerasimov. We found him in the kitchen flirting with the truck-sized waitresses. I gave him the gist of things. He took off his officer's hat and wiped the sweat off his bald spot. "What can I say, Lieutenant Sokov?" I swear, this guy's name changes every time. I don't know which is the correct spelling. I think this is the correct spelling. S-A-C-H-K-O-V. "Anyway, I understand you perfectly. Let's all sit down." We each grabbed an aluminum stool with the wooden top and sat down in the corner. Major leisurely unbuckled his map case, thumbed through the contents, and took out the newspaper. "Red Soldier, a particular favorite of the lower rank, printed on thin wax paper, perfect for rolling your own cigarettes. Gerasimov unfolded the paper and spent a few seconds reading through it, looking for something. "Here's something written for you, just for you, Sokov. Listen carefully." Major read a long article by a front correspondent, Slyapkin, describing the Chinese village liberated by the First Red Banner Army. I think that's us. All the Japanese in the village were shot in the process, of course, and then the Chinese poured out, waving red flags. They were happy beyond belief. As they said, the Japanese had arrived 5 years prior, evicted all the Chinese from their homes, and forbade any non-Japanese to enter the village under the penalty of death. This was followed by a long list of other crimes committed by the Japanese in the village. "You see, Lieutenant, you're not fighting people. You're fighting animals, rabid beasts. Creatures like that don't deserve our pity. They deserve death and nothing but. In which case, in whichever shape it comes, they burned, robbed, and raped the inhabitants of the peaceful village, poor peasants who didn't have anyone to stand up for them. But now, the workers and the peasants, Red Army is here. We're liberating the working class from the vile oppressors, and you seriously think those oppressors deserve your pity?" Skakov, I swear this guy's name changes every time. Skakov's face was changing as if by magic. His eyes were burning, lips pressed tightly together, and fists were clenched. "I felt dirty for bringing the poor kid to Gerasimo, but what else could I do? Really select his missions for him? We'd both get court-martialed." So yeah, little wartime dealio going on here. But anyway, it had nothing to do with anything that we were doing, except for the he felt sorry for the people in the train. I didn't, just fuck him. There was no one there. Train is a train. Anyway, we're gonna take off on the same day, 10th of August. So there'll be our next mission. I'll fly that right after I do this one. Anyway, we're done for this.